Yes, brother.
Assalamualaikum. I would like to know about the Qasr Salah while traveling.
Brother asked the question that while traveling, can we offer Qasr Salah? What is Qasr Salah? Qasr means shortening of the prayers. When you're traveling, you have gone away from your hometown. The distance is there. Some say 80 kilometers, some say 90 kilometers. Little bit difference is there. But when you're traveling away from your home, at that time, you should offer Qasr Salah. Qasr Salah means all the four rakats of Zuhr, Asr, as well as Isha should be shortened to two rakat. That's an advice given. We find the hadith. Unless you're offering in Jama. If you're praying Salah in Jama and the Imam is a Muqeem, he's not a traveler, and if he's offering four rakat of Zuhr, Asr, or Isha, then when you're joining that Jama, you should offer four rakat. But if you're praying individually, or if you've made a group only of travelers, then for Zuhr, Asr, and for Isha, you should offer two rakat. You should not offer four. You should offer two. Unless you're joining a group which is offering four rakat, who is not a traveler. And secondly, you have even option of joining, doing Jama. Doing Jama is not fard. It's not mustahab, it is mubah. You can join your Zuhr and Asr Salah together. And you can join your Maghrib and Isha Salah together. So anytime from the start of Zuhr Salah timing till the end of Asr Salah timing, you can join both together. So you have got freedom because you're traveling in a place, you may not be having that convenience, you may be staying in a place which may not be having facility. So you can offer your Zuhr and Asr together joining anytime from the start of Zuhr Salah. When you pray at the Zuhr time, you're bringing your Asr Salah forward. So you're reading two rakats and two rakats, Asr and Zuhr together. When you're praying at Asr time, you're delaying your Zuhr Salah, both are permitted. Similarly, in Maghrib time and Isha time, you can pray a Maghrib and Isha together from the start of Maghrib time till the end of Isha time. So if you pray Maghrib time both together, you're bringing forward your Isha Salah. If you're praying at afterward Isha time, you're delaying your Maghrib Salah, both allowed. Some schools of thought say, no, only you can delay, you cannot bring it forward. You get both these examples in Hajj. When you go for Hajj, one of the Arkan says that you have to join together. And when you're in Arafat, you're praying your Zuhr and Asr together, you're bringing forward your Asr. And when you leave the Arafat, that time you don't pray. When you come to Muzdalifah, at Isha time, you join your Maghrib and Isha. So you have both the examples in Hajj. So both are permitted depending upon the convenience. So Qasr, if you're praying alone, is a requirement. All four rakats have been done too. And your Fajr Salah remains two rakat and your Maghrib Salah remains three. And during traveling, you should not offer any sunnah except the sunnah of the Fajr. The Fajr, two sunnah before the Farz, two rakat, is a very important sunnah, which while traveling, that you should not miss as far as possible. All the other sunnahs you did not pray, shouldn't pray. If you want to offer as much of nafil, no problem. Hope that answers the question.